going there, I was very, very excited. I was very happy just to be able to be going to the Paralympics, very excited to go see the Paralympic village and see people that I've met at other swimming meets. And when I got there, I was very, very happy to be there, because not only was I going to be with legends, I was also going to get the official title of a Paralympian. And most of the times, you know, TV would introduce me, Uganda's only Paralympian and Uganda's only female Paralympian. And I wouldn't exactly take that. I wouldn't feel good having it until now, where I have actually competed and I've actually earned the title of Paralympian, and I'm really, really happy about that. And overall, I had a lot of fun, and I'm just really happy to be back home and see my siblings, my family, who I haven't seen in like 4 months, because I was in a training camp before going for the Paralympics, and I didn't get to see them a lot, but I still talk to them, and I'm really happy to be here and see them again after a long time. And I can't wait to see how far my journey is going, because right now I'm going to take a short rest and then re-begin training, so that I'm ready for the Commonwealth Games that will be coming next year, and many, many more events to come. And by Paris 2024, I'll be like 17 years, and I will just, hopefully then I can reach the finals and come back with a medal. He's like, saw the dive, I kind of dived in last because my foot kind of slipped, and you know, if you're in the blocks and you slip into the water before the whistle's blown, that's an automatic DQ. And I kind of held back a bit because it's my only race. I can't DQ this race, and it's the only race I have. And I was also kind of nervous before getting into the pool, but I also reminded myself that I have to do my best. But I was only feeling nervous before I got into the blocks. So my foot slipped, and I just had to make sure that I don't fall in. And just when the whistle was actually blown, I dived in and did my best. Yeah, shuffle was kind of tricky. I cut 21 seconds of my previous time, and this time I cut 2 seconds, which means if I keep cutting time gradually all the time, by the time it's Paris 2024, I'll be making an excellent time and maybe get a medal. But I'm sure that I'll qualify. Before all that, like when I first arrived, I was on a strict diet. I didn't eat anything that I wasn't supposed to eat. Not too much sugars. I was strict on whatever the coach told me to eat. And after my race, I feel like a load was taken off me right now. I could eat anything I wanted to eat. I could take a bottle of soda, but it's still a challenge for me to take soda, which I don't take it all the time, so it's a challenge for me to take soda. And I also had some cake, bread, cookies, and I'm pretty sure that will backfire when I go back to training, but at least I'm just really happy that I got the chance to do that. I'm really thankful for my mom. She has really handled me, motivated me, and pushed me whenever I was not feeling like I wanted to do, whenever I didn't want to do something. And I'm also really thankful for my dad. He also motivates me, he pushes me, he reminds me that I'm supposed to do my best in whatever I do. And I'm also really thankful to my coach, because no one else would have trained me to be as good as I am right now. And I'm really, really thankful for him. And I'm thankful to all the well-wishers who have helped me throughout my journey. And I really hope you keep supporting me, and I can't wait to see how proud I can make you. Back then I used to really care much about what people said. Like at school, people would be like, oh, look at that girl, she has no man. Oh my God, that girl with an accident, she doesn't have a man. And that would make me feel stigmatized. But then when I started sport, I started to realize that hiding my hand was pointless, and I don't really have to care about what other people think of me. I don't really have to care about what other people say I look like. And you can't really judge a book by its cover. You have to first get to know the person to know whether they are maybe born like that or they had an accident. And it's kind of wrong to assume, but my advice is just don't care about what society thinks of you, and believe in yourself, and you can achieve anything you want to do.
good. I felt so happy. I mean, everybody was trying to see who is Husna after the announcement that she was the youngest athlete at the Paralympic Games. Everybody was trying to see who is Husna, and from Uganda. So as a mom, as all happy, as very smiling all the time, and as at one time I would get goose pimples, and I'm like, oh, my Husna of yesterday is the celeb at this big event. I was really so happy. I give glory to Allah because it has been a long journey and it is still going on. Really, I love it, and I'm still ready to support Husna until when she achieves her dream of becoming a medalist at the next Paralympic Games, inshallah.
Husna has really demonstrated that being disabled does not mean inability in the first place. And secondly, she has demonstrated the inheritance of sports in our family. My father was a footballer. I was a runner, a golfer, and a footballer, and many others, and many other members of our family are sportsmen. So sports is not new to us. But her achievement is great. Because for me, in 1964, I failed to qualify for Olympics by 2 seconds. Only a world left and I'm cool for the Olympics. So her achievement to go for Olympics is a great achievement for Kanyoma family. And we hope that the young ones, her contemporaries, will emulate from her and also participate actively in sports. We have quite a number who are playing golf, football, but not to her level. We hope this is an inspiration to those young ones so that they can also achieve to the level of Husna.